It's the small, rather exclusive and rather expensive restaurants who suffer most from no shows. They're people who book tables and then don't turn up. The Mijenot here seats 30, so if a party of four fail to come, that's a large chunk of the restaurateur's profits gone. So when owner Neville Bletch took some no-shows to court, claiming breach of contract and won, he was continuing a precedent set by other restaurateurs in highlighting what for them is a major problem. His clientele here today agreed with him. Did you know that the proprietor of this restaurant here has taken somebody to court for booking a table and then cancelling it?
No, I wasn't aware of that, no.
What do you think of the fact that he's done that?
I think he's probably justified, actually.
You approve of that kind of action?
Totally, yes.
Why?
It's unfair to the restaurateur.
If you change your mind, would you ring the restaurant?
Oh, yes.
Have you ever done that?
Frequently.
Don't you think your job is more to serve your clients rather than sue them?
Well, I mean, I don't sort of sue people at the drop of a hat. Either you don't book at all, and then, okay, you take your chances, both of us take our chances, but if you make a booking and you secure a table, that table, I have an obligation to provide that table for you, and that table is kept empty for your own exclusive use. And if you don't honour it, then I suffer a loss.
The Restaurateurs Association of Great Britain believes a blacklist of regular no-shows might help the problem.
We've put together a list of people who we've asked the Restaurateurs Association members to send in a list of people so we can actually cross-reference them to see if they're persistent offenders in more than one restaurant. Therefore, we can allow the members to know who these people are and obviously to take their own action when certain people book.
But surely this blacklist can't possibly work effectively.
Well, it's a start, and I think the publicity we're receiving from it helps tremendously to make people aware of the problem. I think it is an awareness problem.
It's clearly good manners to cancel a booking if you can't turn up, but perhaps the odd threat of legal action might concentrate the minds of regular no-shows a little more. Christopher Rainbow for Thames News.